The snipping tool in Windows just got even better, including, for example, more easily accessible access to the text extraction feature, which, if you didn't know already, is actually really good. For a quick comparison demo, if you compare it to the PowerToys text extraction tool, I took an image of a blurry document that I made, and with the PowerToys one, it got none of it, just a few gibberish characters, whereas the snipping tool one got almost all of it, just a few spots, like four different spots that made a slight single character error. So I'm going to go over some other new features in the snipping tool as well, and also how to enable the features if you don't see them right away. And at the end, I'll even show you an AutoHotkey script I made to launch snipping tool immediately into any of the different capture modes, even the text extraction tool, to save you an entire extra click. Now, first things first, make sure you have the latest version of the snipping tool. You can see the version in the settings menu, and the latest one is 11.2503.29.0. If you don't have the latest version, open up the Microsoft Store. It should show as already being installed through there, but if not, you can just search for it. It's the one from Microsoft. And then you can check for the updates from the Updates and Downloads menu. You just click Check for Updates. And by the way, if you're still on Windows 10, unfortunately, you can't get this latest version. The new version of Snipping Tool, I think, uses Windows APIs that are not in 10 or something. So let's get into the new text extraction button features. And if you don't see these, don't worry, I'll go over that in a second. And I'll also point out that the text extraction feature in general was already in Snipping Tool. It's just now that it's a lot more easy to get to. Previously, you had to take a whole screenshot, then click the text actions thing, and then click copy. It was kind of annoying. But now there is two new buttons. So one is in the main Snipping Tool window. You can click that. Or it also appears in the top toolbar in the capture mode, like if you hit print screen. There's also a couple settings for whether to remove line breaks automatically, and also whether to just immediately copy whatever you select in a region to the clipboard. And it does remember these settings when you change them. If you don't have the automatic clipboard thing selected, it will show you what text it did find in that selected region, and then you can just select individual parts of the text that you want. And there's also right-click options to copy or select all, or you can just click the copy all text thing at the top. The only thing missing I noticed from the main Windows text capture interface is there's no copy as table option, but maybe they'll add that in the future. Anyway, I wanted to do a couple other comparisons to show you just how good it is. So I compared some tests to OneNote, which has a copy text from picture feature, as well as the PowerToys one that I mentioned before. So as an example, I just used a random page from the Apple court ruling recently, since it's a lot of text. And at 100% size, normal document like this, all of them are able to get this ideal situation correct 100%. The only difference is they all replaced the different fancy apostrophes and quotes with the standard ones, but I think you'd want to do that anyway. So if it's text already that's in a perfect image, everything will probably work fine, but I wanted to stress test it, obviously, and that's where I did that blurred one in Photoshop. I already showed you the result with PowerToys. It's just a few random characters of gibberish. And then with OneNote, I also tried it, and that literally didn't copy anything. I don't think it recognized any text. And looking at the result for Snipping Tool, if you're curious what it did get wrong exactly, it seems there were just four mistakes. Three of them were places where it mixed up an R and an N next to each other with an M, which for a blurry image kind of makes sense. And there was another one where it mistook an E for a C. And if you zoom in on the picture, it makes sense why it made those mistakes. And ironically for me, and probably most people, it's actually easier to read if you zoom out, and you could kind of make out what the words actually say. And I believe this does use a neural network AI model behind the scenes, like a small one of some kind. So it probably is looking at like the actual context and trying to figure out what words are in there, but I guess it's still not perfect, or really thought that was a C and an M, but still, four mistakes is not bad for something that crappy looking. Now, is it the absolute best optical character recognition software out there? Probably not. There's probably some paid ones that might be a little better, but considering that, first of all, it is basically better than the free options that I know of, as well as it being pretty much built into Windows, easy to use, it's probably by far the best option for most people if you need to use that. Next, there are actually some other additional features that got added to Notepad recently, specifically having to do with the shapes. So you probably know you can already take a screenshot and draw on it, but now if you hold the mouse after drawing a line, for example, it'll turn it into a straight line that you can adjust as like a shape. And the same goes for squares and stuff like that. And even arrows, it will do the same thing. So there's still limited customization in like the size of the arrows and stuff like that, but I mean, it's still kind of nice. Now, the next thing I can go over is if you don't see the text extraction buttons in the main window of the snipping tool, it's because Microsoft apparently is like rolling out the feature and testing it even if you have the latest version. I hate that. I think they should just give everyone an option to opt in, but you can enable it. You just have to use the Vive tool. It's a pretty well-known tool that basically goes behind the scenes and enables features that are normally disabled or in testing and aren't enabled for everyone. You would just have to run this command with it. Now, you should do this at your own risk, of course. It's an unofficial thing. It uses undocumented APIs. So just be aware if you type in the command wrong or do something wrong, it could mess things up. But if you still want to do it, I'll put the link in the description to the Vive tool and then the command you would run. Or, of course, you can just wait for the feature to fully roll out. It'll probably happen relatively soon. And I will point out, it's not the text extraction feature in general. It's just the extra buttons. So you can still just take a regular screenshot and do that if you want. And also, I believe you don't have to enable the shapes drawing thing. That should be for everyone too. All right, finally though, I'm not finished because there was one thing I really wanted, which was to save that final extra click. You know, okay, you can press print screen and then click the thing to bring up the text extraction, but I wanted a way that would go directly to that tool, kind of like how the Power Toys option has. So if you're someone who uses AutoHotkey, I made a script for myself, but I'll share it with you guys, obviously, where you can import it into your main script. And then there's a couple functions that lets you launch snipping tool directly to any of the different modes, not just the text extractor one, but also the different like rectangle, full screen mode, all that. So it will save you a click or two. I'll just put that link in the description of the GitHub. However, I did not stop there with that script because another annoying thing that I've always hated about the snipping tool is after you take a screenshot, it doesn't open the snipping tool window. It shows a notification that you have to then click on to open it, which is really obnoxious. But the AutoHotkey script, there's an extra parameter that you can set as true, and then it will automatically click that notification for you and save you yet another tiresome click. I know, truly world-changing stuff here. And I will point out, it's a bit more sophisticated than simply clicking on preset regions of mouse coordinates or anything. It actually like finds the exact window and stuff like that. So there's a little bit more to it. It should be pretty reliable. So I would be curious to know what you guys think about this new snipping tool feature. Did you know it could do text extraction at all before? Or maybe you didn't realize just how good it was. Let me know down in the comments. And also let me know if you use the AutoHotkey script, if you find it helpful too. In any case, if you enjoyed the video, of course, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up. It helps out. And if you wanna subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about a weird new folder you may have seen appear in Windows recently and why you should not delete it, the inetpub folder. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.